Thanks for watching TechWiki. Click the subscribe button, then enable notifications with the bell icon so you won't miss any future videos. So unless you're that lady fishing around in her gigantic purse for a checkbook in the grocery lineup, you've probably gotten used to the idea of a paperless, post-cash economy by now. I mean, who wants to carry around a bunch of bills and coins when you can just tap your card and get the same adrenaline rush followed by the same instant regret? So maybe it isn't surprising then that completely digitized forms of currency, namely cryptocurrency, are becoming more popular. We gave a high-level overview in this episode, but today we're going to discuss Bitcoin specifically in a bit more detail because it's the most recognized cryptocurrency at the moment. What is it that makes Bitcoin transactions different from shopping on Amazon with a credit card digitally? Well, you might already know that while normal electronic transactions still involve conventional money, Bitcoin is decentralized, meaning that its distribution and exchange aren't controlled or regulated by a government or other authority. And the technical side of things is also very different. Traditional currency goes through a central payment processor, like your credit card company. But all Bitcoin transactions, whether you're purchasing goods or just sending Bitcoins to a friend because you're a nice guy, are processed by a large distributed network of computers running special software. So whenever a transaction occurs, the network records the sender's and receiver's Bitcoin addresses and the amount transferred and enters this information onto the end of a ledger or record called a blockchain. The blockchain is updated over 100 times per day and is sent to every computer that processes Bitcoin. Because each transaction is encrypted with public key cryptography, which you can learn more about here, and verified by multiple points in the network to ensure that every computer that processes Bitcoin is using identical, correct copies of the blockchain, it is virtually impossible to counterfeit. This verification process is performed by what are called Bitcoin miners, computers or other processing devices that individuals like yourself connect to this large processing network. The mining software that runs works by grouping recent transactions into blocks, which are only accepted by the rest of the network if the block is hashed correctly, which requires the computer to find correct numerical values, a time-consuming and compute-intensive process. But what's in it then for the members of the processing network? Ah, I'm glad you asked. So, once a computer does successfully process a block, it's added to the blockchain, and the system generates a new Bitcoin that goes into the miner's digital wallet as a reward. So your computer ends up literally creating money for you out of nothing. So, wow, where do I sign up? You can just mine Bitcoin and never work again? Well, it's a bit more complicated than that. It takes a lot of processing power to generate an appreciable amount of Bitcoin. And since the system is designed for it to take about 10 minutes to successfully process a block, the difficulty of mining generally increases as more nodes join the network. Not to mention that the costs of entry are fairly high. In the early days, you could mine on your spare laptop. Then, for a while, high-end graphics cards were popular choices thanks to their highly parallelized, number-crunching optimized architectures. But these days, though it should be noted that this doesn't necessarily apply to other cryptocurrencies, these days, Bitcoin can only really be profitably mined using specialized mining appliances called ASIC miners. Unlike graphics cards, these can only be used for Bitcoin mining in most cases, and they can cost thousands of dollars each. Oh yeah, and they suck a ton of power too, which, due to high electricity rates in many parts of the world, can kill any chance of profitability for the average person. So it's obvious why people are mining Bitcoin. I mean, there's profit to be made, but why do other people want it? Well, Some people are mistrustful of banks and governments to keep their money secure and have a lot more faith in Bitcoin's redundant blockchain system, especially as more and more retailers begin to accept cryptocurrency. Others like the partial anonymity that Bitcoin offers. The only thing that necessarily ties you to a particular Bitcoin address is an encryption key. Plus, you could grab a new address for each transaction you make. In fact, many paid VPN services accept Bitcoin payment for people who are concerned about staying incognito online. Still others look at Bitcoin as an investment, though you should tread carefully here. Because Bitcoin is completely unregulated, there is no guarantee of its value, not even a flimsy one. So investing lots of money in Bitcoin, at least for now, is considered speculative level risk. However, the system is designed so that by the year 2140, no new Bitcoin will be produced, leading some to believe that down the line it'll be a more secure virtual commodity of sorts that will provide a hedge against inflation of traditional currencies. Kind of like how some people invest in gold bars for the same reason. Which sounds cool in theory, but right now, Bitcoin is a bit of a roller coaster. The value of one Bitcoin recently jumped from a few hundred dollars in 2016 to nearly $20,000 around the edge of 2017.